Let's check out this great acoustic tune from Neil Young. I love teaching this song because it gives me a chance to talk about some subtle details with the right hand. So often we focus on which fret to finger, right? Which chord to play. Right hand, your picking hand, has so much to contribute to the overall sound of the tune, and this is a time for us to talk about that. So what I want you to think about here is two different pick grips, meaning a tight grip for this sound and a much looser grip for those little casual strums that are interspersed here. If you do it right, you're going to sound like two different guitar players, and you'll hear what I mean as I play it in a minute. But that's a goal for you, maybe not in the beginning, but as the ultimate goal for your progress on your picking hand. Have it sound like you're two different guitar players with a tight grip for those individual strings and a looser grip for the strumming. This technique is going to help you play a lot of songs in a much more authentic way. And it's subtle, but it's definitely there, tight versus loose. Now let's talk about the left hand and putting the two hands together. First things first, the song Neil Young has his guitar tuned down a whole step. I do not have my guitar tuned down a whole step, but to play along with the original, you're going to have to do that. From the sixth string down, D, G, C, F, A, D. Okay, no reason to retune your guitar unless you're going to play along with the original tune. But now you know, I'm in standard tuning here. Chords are the A minor chord, the G chord, and an F major 7 with an open A string as the bass note. Officially it'll be called F major 7 slash A because of that open A string ring there. Beautiful chord. And before I get into the Neil Young song here, I want to remind you that this version of an F chord, an F major 7, often it sounds great as an alternative to a regular F major chord. So if you've never played it before, consider fingering this F major 7 slash A chord in the place of an F chord and see if you like the results, especially if you're really struggling with a traditional F chord. Okay, well, here we go with my hey hey. I'm going to grab my A minor chord first. Nice down stroke on the fifth string. And a nice light down up. And I'm emphasizing the treble strings. Don't worry about how many strings you're going to hit. Maybe three strings going down, maybe two on the way up. The important thing is that soft, quiet tone of the loose grip and down up. Now here comes an easy riff, right? Second finger, third finger, open G with the second, third, and fourth fingers, okay? Yes, you could play G with the index finger over here. I don't recommend it for this tune. If you've never played this G before, now's the time. Okay, so far we have a little up, down, up. You might say, hey, why am I even fingering these notes if I'm not going to strum those, if I'm just going up, down, up on the treble strings? It's a valid point. I think you should master this version of doing G no matter what for a variety of reasons, including, hey, if you happen to hit one of those strings by mistake, obviously, it's not really a mistake. It sounds just fine at part of the chord. So I do encourage you to play a full G chord rather than just finger the skinny string there, even though, yes, technically you could get away with that. Down, up. Up, down, up. Okay, the ups and downs are important. Take note of those. And now the final riff. My second finger is already in the right note. Third finger. There's the open A string. As I'm plucking that open A string, I'm getting this F major 7 chord in place. Okay, super important that as you play that open fifth string, your fretting hand is in motion. I call it, it's in motion. Okay? Down, up, down, up, up, down, up, down, up. Now, I'm going to teach you this riff, I am teaching you this riff, as one specific isolated thing. The fact is Neil Young is taking lots of liberties, and probably every time he plays it, things change a little bit. Let's learn it this way, and then you can find some variations on your own. Okay, so I left you here with a F major 7. Up, down, down, up, down, up, up, down, up, down, up. And that leads you right back into the riff. Some other things to think about. On those individual notes, first of all, I encourage you to practice those separately without the strumming, just to get really good at moving your left-hand fingers around. You know, you should be able to do that in your sleep. And then you can add in the chords if necessary, if that's a good strategy for you to master it. Second thing I want to mention is, I guess you could do all those individual notes as downstrokes. During today's video just now, I could feel myself sometimes doing them with all downstrokes, sometimes alternating down and up. When in doubt, in this case, I would say just do all downstrokes for those, let's call them melody notes. There's no pressing reason not to do all downstrokes, so I guess I would encourage you to do all downstrokes and worry about other stuff, including, like I said, your pick grip tension and getting your left hand to cooperate. Okay, so that is the riff for My My Hey Hey. He's built the whole song on that A minor, G, F major 7 chord progression. Again, he's got his guitar tuned down. And like I said before, as a guitar teacher, I love this tune because it allows us to talk about some real subtleties going on, not only with the grip of the pick, but also with, you know, reaching in and getting those individual notes, even amidst the chord changing, you know. Great skill. Some of you out there already have that skill, terrific. But for those of you who haven't mixed bass notes, I'll call them melody notes, but on the bass strings, if you haven't done that, where you mix those notes in with the chords, this is a great song to start off with. Definitely, it's not too fast. The chords are not too tricky. I know that G with their second, third, and fourth fingers might seem a little bit odd if you haven't done it before. No, it's okay. You get used to it. This is a great opportunity to get used to it. All right, so there you have it. Thanks to Neil Young, My My Hey Hey. I had some questions about what you see at the bottom of the screen there. www.song-bike.com. That's my website where you can become a member for 10 bucks a month, and you get access to tons of videos that I don't have up on YouTube. A lot of great stuff that's structured, organized, and I think you really like it. So check out that that website down there, www.song-bike.com, and I think you really like it. Try it for a month for 10 bucks, or for a year for 100 bucks, and you pay through PayPal, easy peasy. And I think you really like it. Don't forget to like and comment on this video and to subscribe to this YouTube channel. I appreciate it, everybody, and I'll see you next time.